What's it doing at the Home Depot?
Wow.
He needs a little home repair. He's building a place.
He's looking for a home.
They can do that kind of thing. I mean, yeah. You know.
Opposable thumbs.
Yeah. They carry lumber and what they need. To...
Or the takeover is happening right now.
It's all over.
Hey, we hope fall is going to take over
this
weekend on.
I haven't heard anyone say, let's just keep the humidity around for the entire year. Let's go ahead and move forward with that. We do have some drier air overhead right now, but we're still muggy down at ground level. So just a few afternoon storms as the dry air will again limit our storm chance into the afternoon, although there is a chance for a couple of storms. I'll highlight it for you in just a bit. Right now we're in the mid to upper 80s, so hot, muggy, you bet. Look at the heat index, low and mid 90s as of the noon hour. So if you're going to be out there for a while working, got the golf round going on here on a Wednesday, take a lot of breaks, drink a lot of water, upper 80s at the beach. Our sea breeze already moving in, so we should stay in check there. 91 in Orlando, 92 around Winter Haven. There's the dry air coming in on the water vapor picture, that orange color just shooting across the Gulf of Mexico right over central Florida. But there's a storm system rolling through the deep south, and you can see this nasty line of storms coming into Tallahassee this afternoon. And these are likely going to be weakening as they get into North Florida and down into our northern parts of our viewing area into the afternoon because of that dry air. But nevertheless, you see by 3 o'clock, a couple of isolated showers and storms trying to crank up along our sea breezes. There's Brevard and Flagler County through 5 o'clock. Notice the metro area still fairly dry, but by 7, our sea breezes are trying to collide here, so you can't rule out a quick pop-up shower or thunder shower on and toward dinner time as well. Now let's go over to the tropics. We have Ophelia and Philippe, both tropical storms way out over the Atlantic. Here's Philippe. It's likely just going to continue to weaken, possibly even just dissipate as we go through the week, so no concern there. Ophelia is likely going to pass just east of Bermuda as even a hurricane over the weekend. Now our weekend forecast, though, looks pretty good. Here's a look at tomorrow. We do have at least a slight chance of a shower storm, especially Orlando north, as this first little piece of energy rolls by. Looks like most of the moisture will be south of the metro area by Friday. So still a 20% chance of rain Friday, but lower humidity to the north by Friday afternoon and evening. And then over the weekend, here comes that shot of north winds. Ophelia's way off to our east. We're just breezy and dry, feeling more like the middle of October with mid-80s and mid-60s in the outlook. So your 7-day forecast, hot and humid today, 90 at 3 and 5 o'clock. There's that late-day storm chance, only at around 20 to 30% at most the next couple of days. And we're going to keep it hot and humid on Thursday. By Friday night, though, some of us are up to the north. They're going to start feeling a little less humid. And then over the weekend, looks great. Enjoy. See you on Jason. Back to you.